subscribe and hit the bell icon for more notifications.
Hi guys, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to see what are the common mistakes which have to be avoided for your NSET exam preparation and during your NSET exam. Okay, so yes, now let's begin this video without any delay. First, let's discuss what are the mistakes which have to be avoided during your preparation, NSET preparation, okay? And then let's see mistakes to be avoided during your exam. So yes, first coming to mistakes that have to be avoided during your preparation. First common mistake is students who ever study something, if they don't revise, that is the first common mistake. If you study a concept and leave it without revision, you're not going to remember it at all. Remember this point, okay? So whatever you study, at the end of the day, you have to revise it again. Then only you can remember it easily in your exam, okay? Important. And next important mistake which you must avoid is students will be, you know, fluctuating in between the subjects. For example, half an hour they'll do mathematics and next half an hour they'll go for physics or chemistry. This is absolutely wrong thing, and this is one of the common mistake which students have to stop while preparation. Okay guys, once you give at least 1 or 2 hours for a subject, then only you will effectively learn the concepts, okay? So for example, half an hour mathematics, and immediately after half an hour if you shift for chemistry, your mind will take time to set, okay? First of all, it has to understand the concepts, okay? So it will be like in a confusion stage, so that all the time will be wasted at the end of the day. That's why give at least 1.5 to 2 hours for every subject. Take a break at least for 10 or 15 minutes and then you can shift to next subject. Okay, this is the important thing which you have to repeat. Remember, these two are the common mistakes which most of the students do, and you have to avoid them while your preparation. Now let's see what are the common mistakes which you have to avoid in your exam. Okay, the D-Day, the NSET final exam day. What you have to do? First mistakes which you have to not do is, guys, I have already made a video recently telling how to attempt NSET online exam. If you haven't watched that yet, that video is going to be in the description box below. That link will be in the description down. You can watch it once you're done watching this video. Okay, so first guys, you will in your final NSET exam, in your main NSET exam, you will have the option of fluctuating. There'll be three options: mathematics, physics, chemistry. I'm taking the example of MBC students. Okay, so YPC students, don't worry. You'll have like three options: mathematics, physics, chemistry. Okay, so most of the students, mainly what will they do? They will go for max, solve 10 questions. If they feel max is hard, then they'll go to physics, solve 2 questions. If they feel it is hard or boring, they'll again shift. Don't do that mistake, because coming to the MCET online exam, time management is the most important thing, guys. Remember this, okay? So that's why please don't waste your time by, just fluctuating. Obviously, when you fluctuate or when you keep, moving on from one subject to other subject, it will be waste of the time, okay? Sincerely, I'm saying you, seriously, I'm telling you, it's waste of time. And in order to get a good score or good rank in your NSET, time management is really, really important. That's why please don't waste your time. First, go to a subject. You'll have three subjects: mathematics, physics, chemistry. First, fix your mind and select one subject. For example, if you selected physics, complete, you have to answer them it completely, and then only you have to go to the next subject. It might be either mathematics or chemistry, but don't do the mistake of, solving 10 questions from mathematics and then 2 questions from physics or 5 questions from chemistry. Don't do that mistake. Go to a subject, solve it completely, and then go for next thing. Okay. And yes, this is the first common mistake which you have to avoid. Coming to the second common mistake, most of the students will, if they feel a particular question is hard, they will keep wasting the time in that question. For example, you started solving a problem in mathematics, okay, and after reading the question, you felt you know the answer and you started solving, okay. It's been 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 5 minutes, and still you sat and you know you are still continuing to solve the problem. Obviously, please don't do this kind of mistake, because Eamcet is having a very, very limited time, okay? You just have 180 minutes for your exam. You can't give 5 minutes or 10 minutes for a single question. Sit on the question for 2 minutes. If you're not getting that question, shift. If you're not getting that question, or if you're not understanding what the question is all about, then go to next question. But don't waste your time by just, you know, trying on trying, okay? So max for 1 to 2 questions, I think you can give 2 to 3 minutes, but more than that you should not, okay? You know, out of all the questions of mathematics, at maximum just give a priority to only 2 to 3 questions where you can spend 3 minutes max, okay? But for rest of the questions in mathematics, you have to give only 30 to 60 seconds, that's it. Don't waste your time, okay? And mainly, the tip, I'm going to give you a pro tip here, okay? What is that is, guys, especially for mathematics students, MPC students, if you want to save a lot of time, first go for physics and chemistry, because they are like, you know, mostly they are of like theoretical questions. Physics will have problems also. First go to chemistry, solve the theoretical questions quickly, go to physics, answer them quickly and solve the problems of the physics, and then quickly go to your mathematics and give like, you know, give complete time for that, okay? So that, you know, why I'm telling you like this is because chemistry is having just your you know, your theoretical questions. For every theoretical question, maximum you can spend up to 20 to 30 seconds per question, not more than that. So that once you end up solving both this chapter, both these subjects, and then once you go to mathematics, you will save a lot of time, trust me, okay? And yes, these are like the main mistakes which you have to avoid, okay? So yes, and guys, I'm going to give you a suggestion. Once you sit in front of your PC, check the things, okay? Is it your number? Is it your name? Does the PC belongs to you or not? Do all these prior checkings, okay? So most of the students will, you know, start seeing surroundings, okay? They'll waste all the time, and once the exam is about to begin, then they'll realize that it's not their system, and there's a lot of time wasted after that, and you'll be nervous, which will ultimately impact your exam and your performance in exam, okay? So that's why don't do this silly mistakes. And main mistake which you have to avoid is, guys, few center names may be common, okay? So that's why see the location of the center also, okay? And it's suggested if you go to the center and visit the center one day at least prior your exam, it will be really helpful, because once you go and see your exam center, and if you confirm that it's your exam center, next day there will be no surprises, no last minute surprises. That's why, and you'll be confident because you've already you know, visited your exam center, so thus you'll be like, you know, very, very confident, and you can directly visit there in your, on your exam day, okay? So even this is important. So don't do the mistake of, you know, getting confused with your exam centers and all, because Eamcet, for Eamcet exam or any other competitive exam, even if you're late for 1 to 2 minutes or any couple of minutes, they're not going to allow you for the exam. So that's why be punctual, okay? So don't do these kind of silly mistakes which will impact your performance. That's why, guys, be careful and all the very best for your exam, okay? So yes, that's it for today. Hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon, And also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. Thanks for watching, and see you in my next video.